Catherine.
Derrick, I was wondering if you could talk about the event where you're going to be speaking on Saturday. I think you might be a little bit modest about your ability to reach people of all races, because I have seen you in front of these audiences, and the one on Saturday, I expect you will be picking up some new converts.
A gentleman by the name of David Crooks had his home raided 11 p.m. at night. A warrant signed on the word of a man who had just burglarized his home. Now that was a story that we were given. The police went to his home, cars screeching, no sirens, and they proceeded to go and kick the door in. The wife, Mrs. Hooks, is awakened. She warns her husband that the crooks are returning home. He grabs his weapon to defend his home, one of our constitutional protections, right to privacy, property rights. We even have a castle law here in Georgia. He was going to defend his home. He's not a crook. Man had contracts with a military base, been investigated by Homeland Security, GBI, FBI, background, two successful businesses. Yet he was being raided in the middle of the night. And he was shot and killed by the police. 19 or so shots were fired. Now, you didn't hear about that because it doesn't fit the narrative of division. Well, why didn't you hear about that? Because then, particularly white America would know that it could happen to them too. You see, when I was running before, I would say to people, the attack on the Second Amendment is not to reduce crime. The attack on the Second Amendment is to disarm those who own most of the guns legally in this country, middle class white America. They want to know what you got, how much ammo you have, and what the capabilities of it are in addition to where you live. So when they come knocking, they don't want you to possess the ability to defend yourself against an unlawful search and seizure, or one where the warrant is questionable at best, and in this particular case, it was. See, Mr. Hooks is something that shows that the liberties and freedoms of this country are being eroded day by day. Obama said, all right, we're going to put cameras on the police. That is not to protect us. That's to give the federal government more reach into local police control. Everything that the government puts money towards, our taxpayer money, by the way, they end up controlling it. They're giving them tanks, flashbang grenades, bayonets, bulletproof vests, night goggles, masks, the whole nine yards. Now he's gonna give them cameras, and he said, words out of his own mouth, I'm still going to let them keep their military hardware. They don't want white America hip to what's taking place under your noses. Because if you were to wake up and realize the slippery slope that we were headed down, you'd do something different. That's why I'm telling you. That's why I'm warning you. If they can do this to Mr. Hooks, a law-abiding citizen, they can do it to you. And they will. I keep telling you, 1,500 blacks killed by police, 2,500 whites killed by police. They aren't just killing black people. The police are killing white people. They follow orders. But none of that will change if we don't change the people who make the laws and the policies that the police are carrying out. That is on us. That's our job.